today. Thanks for the invitation. So a couple of disclaimers off the bat. I have only been at the Historical Society for a few months, as I mentioned. And it's been really exciting and fun, but really, really busy because we kicked off the biggest exhibition the museum's ever done when I came on board. The other disclaimer, my kids are in China, close to the North Korean border and the Russian border, so I told them not to take any long walks while they're up there. But I got a call at midnight last night that my daughter was in the hospital in China. So I was up for about 3 hours last night on the phone, back and forth with the teacher that they're with. She's okay, she has an intestinal infection, so they thought it might be appendicitis. So she's okay, but very worrying being this far away from my 16-year-old little girl. She's actually adopted from China, and this is her first visit back to China since she was adopted. My son is there too, so he was by her side, and that made me feel better. Anyway, I might be a little groggy and a little bit lower energy than I normally would be, so just putting that out there. I really appreciated listening to the discussion this morning and all of the focus that Rotary has on history and education and service and learning, because that's what the Historical Society is all about as well. And I'd like to know if any of you are members. Anyone in here a member of the Washington State Historical Society? Yay! You get a prize.
Oh.
I'm going to give you a football. One of those special squeezy, if you can celebrate your anniversary, squeeze out the stress. I don't want to throw it, I want it to land in someone's coffee.
Thank you.
It's not that good of a shot. How many of you have been to the History Museum in Tacoma? Wow, lots of you. Great. Okay, that's really good to know. I'm going to pass around this bag, and if you would like to put your business card in here, great. I would love to add you to our email list that just gives you once a month, this is what's happening at the museum. You can disengage if you find it that you're not interested. And I would like to draw some prizes out. So go ahead if you're so inclined. I normally bring a fishbowl, but I don't have that today. Does anyone know what the current exhibition is? The big blockbuster with the summer?
No.
It has something to do with the thing I just handed up, the football. It's Gridiron Glory, the best of the Pro Football Hall of Fame. And you might wonder what that has to do with Washington history. We feel like the history of football is very much reflective of the history of our country. When you look at a lot of the concerns and a lot of the social development that happened in our country, football started happening and becoming a big deal because people eventually had free time. You know, they stopped working in the fields as much, started moving into cities, had a little disposable income, had some free time, and football became one of the popular sports and now is our nation's favorite sport. Racial integration is part of the story of football, equality, so lots of cultural changes were reflected in the development of football. So this exhibit, if you're not a football fan, it's still interesting. There's still lots of interesting moments. And we're the only museum in the whole Pacific Northwest, we're the only place where this exhibit's gonna be on view. So it's on view through September 10th. There's a ton of really fun interactives. You can compare your body size. There's these molds of linebackers. And you can stand next to these leg molds. Most of you will be able to fit your entire body inside one leg of one of these guys. So it gives you a real perspective. There's a lot of, there's molds of the biceps. I took the Chinese kids when they were here in there, and they were flabbergasted at the size of these guys. So it's just really fun to go see and check out. You can step into an instant replay booth and make a call, all those kind of things. So I'm gonna pass these out too, about our current exhibit. Please take some to pass out to friends, and I encourage you all to come in. This is our quarterly printed newsletter that goes to members, and this will tell you about the newest exhibit in our permanent exhibits that's opening this summer. It's called Washington, My Home. It should open by the end of this month, and it's about immigration. So people who come from all over the world and the trials and tribulations that they've gone through is told, much of it is told in first-person narratives. You'll be able to listen to recordings of immigrants and their stories and how they got here. So very interesting, since most of us were not Native American. We all come from somewhere. Our families come from somewhere else. So this is very reflective of how people got to our state and what they went through. On the back side, you'll find upcoming events that are happening. So I have some trivia questions. I know you guys already had trivia this morning, but I'm going to ask you anyway. Does anyone know what year Washington became a state?
1846.
Not 1846?
1889.
Not 87? You said 89. Raise your hand if you said, raise your hands and hold them up if you said 89. I'm going to give you a prize. I'm sorry, you got to hold them up longer. Who's an 89? You're an 89? Football for you? Who else is an 89? Poster? Anyone else? Anyone who likes to drink pints of beer? Speaking of pints of beer, we are starting 21 plus events. So we've had two 21 plus events that have been really fun. One associated with the exhibition Steins, Vines, and Grinds about coffee and wine and beer in our state.
Oh.
And then we had another 21 plus event that was recently associated with football. It was called Two Pint Conversion. We have another one coming up this fall with an exhibit called Glasnost and Goodwill, which is about Washington citizens who helped thaw the Cold War. Lots of really interesting stories in that. And there will be a, that was, you know, the Cold War, the space race and all that, all of those things that kind of happened simultaneously. We've tied that into a UFO night, so you can come and make a UFO and have some local beer. Green Magnets Brewing will be there, and there will be a film, a couple of filmmakers in Seattle that have done a film about a UFO sighting in Washington State, and it'll be the premiere of that film. So another question for you, let's see, who knows when women got the right to vote in Washington? Does anyone know that one? Anyone have a guess?
20s.
I'm hearing 20s, 30s. 27? It was actually 1910, just before it was ratified nationally. So we have a Women's History Consortium at Washington State Historical Society to help educate people about that. And how many counties are in Washington? Anyone know that one?
39.
Awesome!
Don't give me a prize, that's totally cheating.
Because she's, yeah.
I'm a county auditor.
So Columbia is our quarterly history journal, and not too scholarly, it's friendly, anybody can read it and enjoy it. If you're a history, anyone in here really into history? Love history? Oh my God, I'm here. All right, these are super interesting. I've got a few more copies up here if anybody wants to grab on the way out. And my business card is up here too. Let me do a few more prizes. Let's see.
They're gonna want you to come back again.
Michael McCrapp? Oh. W. Michael McCrapp? All right. Give you a poster and a football.
There
you go. Excuse me. There you go. I'm gonna give away all my swag before I start running through this presentation. Let's see, who else do I have here? American Underwriters, Nick Stay. All right. Find someone who loves pints of beer. Let's see, who else? Bristol Cone, Bailey Martin. Bailey's the
designer.
You're here. It's my lucky day.
Did you buy a raffle ticket?
You must be present to win.
Bosses are going to love that.
He'll let you come in.
Yeah.
And let's do one. We'll do a couple more. I have some passes, too. All right. If you guys don't mind coming up, I've got, let's see. Geyser?
Yeah, that's her.
Yeah.
When people take a break before reading this.
Yeah. I'll pass for you to come visit the museum. Can you come up and get that? And let's see, who else do I have? Oh, Mr. Gray. Mr. Gray, the history questioner.
This is a great magazine, you guys. I'm going to pass it around. It's really cool.
And then Rick Carr. Oh, the anniversary guy. He's got double prizes today. Yeah, there. I'll pass these out too. There's a couple more issues. You guys can pass those out and take a look. There you go.
Thank you.
Yeah,
17.
So the Washington State Historical Society was established about 126 years ago. And what we like to say is that we, the past is present. We are living history. So what we're doing today, of course, will be history someday. We had several quotes this morning about memory and history becoming memory, or memory becoming history, and a small group of citizens enacting change. And that is very much reflected in what you'll see at the Washington State History Museum and throughout the Historical Society. So we work to make connections between the past and the present and help people understand the value of history. And then, of course, we help to preserve the history of our state and people's stories. You might think of, I don't know, if you're like me when you were in school, you didn't really love history. 126 years old, that's us. So I find it helpful to take the word his out of history and just say story, because we all love stories, and that's what history is. We are constantly interpreting and reinterpreting history, and I think if you went to the History Museum when you were in fourth grade and you did a tour, you know, a field trip with your class, you're gonna find that things are portrayed much differently now. Even if you were in 10 years ago, you're going to find that things are portrayed differently. Columbia Magazine is all about current historical scholarship and reinterpreting our past and revisiting themes. I'm having a little bit of trouble reading this. So when we were founded, Benjamin Harrison was president. The International Copyright Act was passed that year. Thomas Edison was showing his first prototype kinetoscope, which was an early cinematography piece. Civil War General William Sherman passed away, and Seattle University was founded that year, so one of the oldest universities in our state. I'm not going to run you through our first mission. It seems to be not, it's not moving.
No.
Turning.
Chris, you need
is
to
go.
Is it frozen?
Yeah, it seems to be frozen.
So I move.
Yeah, we have a little spinning wheel.
That thing is.
Sure. All right. Now it's probably going to go six slides ahead since I pushed it.
Still
running. Looks like it's working now. So as I said, our mission is to partner with our communities and explore how history connects us all. Skip through some of these. This is actually a fundraising presentation, which I don't think you guys need to hear. But I want to get to some of the broader things that this Historical Society does. So the people in Tacoma often associate us just with the museum, and that is our largest and most visible activity. But as a state historical society, we have activities all across the state. One of my favorite activities is History Day. Did any of you participate in History Day in school? Anyone part of that? A couple of nods over there. This year, it's a national program, and every state does it a little bit differently. So there are competitions at the local level, regional level, district level, and then national level. Every year, Washington sends kids to nationals. So this year in our state, this program is run through the Historical Society. And this year in our state, almost 9,000 kids across our state participated in this program. And over 50 of them went to nationals. So that's a really good showing, and it speaks very well to what teachers are doing and what volunteers are doing in this state. Because a lot of we couldn't run this program without a huge slate of volunteers. I'm really proud of our students, and I'm really proud of this program. This is one of the things that connects our organization around our state. And it's great to bring younger kids, you know, to really young kids who are interested in history, they're maybe not the most popular kids in school. So they're, you know, this is great for them to be able to have a venue where they can compete and they can really push their learning. And we've had kids go on to get scholarships to schools like Tufts. So it's really this national competition, they win prizes. One of them got to do a documentary with the History Channel a couple of years ago. So it's a pretty big deal, and they do very high-level work. So I would encourage you to check that out on our website if you have kids that are in school or if you've got grandkids or anything like that. Another one of our statewide initiatives is the Women's History Consortium. And then we also have Heritage Capital Projects, where we give grants and we work with organizations around the state to rehabilitate buildings and establish trails. We just helped open a heritage trail for the Tulalip tribe. So those projects go on around the state too. So we've got the History Museum here in town. We also have the Research Center, which was the original History Museum, gorgeous building by Stadium High School. And that's open to the public, we keep that open to the public to be able to go in and do research. Heritage Capital Projects, which I just mentioned. Our K-12 education services, we have traveling exhibits that go out to schools. We have downloadable exhibitions and curriculum on our website that our staff help develop and our curators. And then, of course, we have thousands every year, thousands of students that come through the museum and do programming there. We also do family programs. Kids can come in and do make volcanoes. We just did that recently. They make things that explode. It's really fun. And learn about the geological history of our state. Lots of different, and we do an Oregon Trail program. There's a gold panning program where the families can come in and pan for gold. Lots of public programs and events, the new 21 Plus series that I was talking about. With Gridiron Glory on the back of your rack card, you'll see a whole list of public programs and events that were associated with that. So most of our larger exhibitions will have two or three public programs that are open to anyone. Members get discounts. You can come in just for the program, or you can come in and see the exhibitions, and then the program is free. The program costs are very low. We work really hard to keep our admission prices and our programs really low. So some of our funding comes from the state, but not all of it. We do depend on development for, you know, contributions to keep the museum open and keep the society going. Of course, we have great exhibits, always rotating those. This is our beautiful building. It's right down next to the courthouse, if anyone hasn't seen it or been down there, Pacific Avenue. About 20 years old. This is the exhibition that's opening later this month, Washington, My Home. And when you walk in, you'll see these beautiful illuminated arrival windows. This is this exhibition is very much in line with contemporary museum practices. There is lots of artifacts that people have brought with them on their travels from other countries. There's a part of it called Step Into My Shoe, where you'll pick a shoe and then you listen to the story of the person who wore that shoe into the state and made their home here. And there's a part for you to share your story too. So you can share about how your family came to the state, which was a topic in our last member newsletter, and I got a lot of interesting feedback from people just asking that question casually. Oh no, what happened? Okay, well, we've lost it. That's okay. One thing I'd like to ask all of you is, we also have a model train. Anyone in here a model train person? We just had a big convention, I don't know if you're aware, in Tacoma, of model train people. There are lots of model train people out there. So we had 89 people come through our museum to see our model train during this convention that was here. So model train is open. The model train in the museum is open all year. It's one of the biggest model trains that's on permanent view in the Pacific Northwest. And then every December, we have a model train festival. Great for kids, wonderful Christmas time activity. We bring a Santa in for a few days. Lots of great family activity. So I wanted to ask everyone in here, you know, the people who haven't been to the History Museum, and those who have, you know, has anyone been recently? We're very curious about how people hear about us, me in particular, working in marketing. Communication is changing, as everyone knows, and the way we consume media has changed quite a bit. We choose what we want to see and when we want to see it. So for us at the Historical Society, trying to reach people about all of our events and about all of these interesting things that are happening and how it relates to them, you know, it's a challenge in this changing media landscape. So I'm very curious about how you guys decide what you're gonna do if you've got a Saturday afternoon and your kids are with you, or you've got a Saturday and you've got visitors in town. How do you choose the activities that you're gonna do and where you go? Anyone have any feedback?
From friends.
From friends, word of mouth, just from friends. That's what I hear most commonly, is word of mouth and from friends. And I'm wondering, where did the friends get their information? You know, where are the friends, how are the friends influenced by what they see or where they look things up?
I was looking at what the museums are doing online, but I have a question back to you. I know, like, one of our members mentioned that there was a water skiing competition last weekend, and that nobody knew about the tall ships. I hardly saw anything about where are Tacoma activities being advertised right now.
Yeah, we at the Art Museum, we had a lot of...
News Tribune?
Right, yeah, the News Tribune, KUOW, KNKX. So we were able to get a lot of coverage on the bigger stations, and radio stations, and the newspapers and magazines, Seattle Net, Seattle Magazine, a lot of those magazines too. South Sound published a lot about us at our museum. So at the History Museum, I'm hoping to bring that in too and help get things out in print. We have a very small advertising budget at the History Museum, which is both because we're a nonprofit, but also because a lot of our funding comes from the state. The way our funding is allocated is very much toward education and exhibitions, not toward advertising. So what we do there, I send out a press release with all of our upcoming activities quarterly, and then I send out press releases for every new exhibition. So it does get to the media, and things, I have seen things listed in the TNT in their calendar section. I've seen things listed on South Sound, on Parent Map. They send out e-blasts. We have a lot of social media, so we have 3 Facebook pages actually associated with the society. So I post on 3 different Facebook pages. We do events on Facebook pages, and then we do Twitter and Instagram. The thing with Facebook, as probably most of you know, if you don't go to the Historical Society's page and like a few things, it's not going to appear in your stream. When you're on your Facebook page, your homepage, looking at things that just come through. If you go to the Historical Society and check things out and like a few of our posts, then you'll start getting those in your stream. So you'll become more aware of the events that are happening. Our website, you know, we always have information on the website about events and exhibitions. So we're putting it out there. We do some paid advertising. So I have done a little bit of paid advertising this last few months that I've been there. And that's what I'm really curious about is that, you know, we're putting the information out there and it is being picked up here and there. We got the front page Friday before the exhibition opened for Gridiron Glory, the front page of the News Tribune. So